Sometimes we're disappointed over what we've lost. We know it was good. It represented favor, but it didn't last. The door closed. The loan didn't go through. The person walked away. We don't understand why it didn't work out. Why did I lose this coat of many colors? It meant so much to me. But if you only knew what God was about to do, if you could see the coat of influence, the coat of honor, the coat of authority that's coming, you would understand that it's all a part of God's plan. You have to trust Him when it doesn't make sense. He's not going to let you lose your coat of many colors unless there's a royal robe that's in your future. If you only knew where those disappointments are leading you, like with Joseph, you had to get pushed out. They had to be jealous. They had to betray you. It's not that God has forgotten about you. It's that He's positioning you for greater influence, greater honor, greater favor. Can He trust you when the robe of many colors is taken? Will you keep a good attitude, not get bitter, not think you've seen your best days? Joseph had plenty of opportunities to give up on his dream, in the pit, feeling forgotten, working in a foreign country against his will, in prison for something that he didn't do. How did he stay encouraged? I believe the same God that came to the well to meet the woman who was hurting, the same God that came to my father when he was heartbroken, came to Joseph and whispered, "If you only knew what I'm about to do, if you only knew how I'm going to connect the dots, if you only knew how you'll never miss this robe of many colors when I get finished." That still small voice kept reminding him that God is in control, that his steps were being ordered, that what God started, he would finish. Are you discouraged over what didn't work out? Who did you wrong? Why is it taking so long? If you only knew what God was up to, if you only knew the doors he's about to open, if you only knew how he's going to vindicate you, heal you, promote you, then you would trust him while you don't understand. Stay in faith when it doesn't make sense. Do the right thing when the wrong thing has happened. The fact that you lost the robe of many colors, you've been through disappointments, betrayals, injustice, that's a sign that something awesome is on the way. What God is about to do in your life will not just make up for every wrong, every injustice, but it will be so rewarding you won't think about what you lost. I heard about this young lady. She was going to meet her fiancé's parents for the first time. They were known to be very picky and not easily impressed, and she was nervous about it all. And she made sure her outfit was perfect and she looked the best that she possibly could. But on the way out the door, she accidentally knocked a can of Coca-Cola over. It hit the floor and splashed up on her shoes and pant legs. And she couldn't believe it. Of all times, she was trying to look good and this happened. She didn't have time to change, so she just wiped it off the best she could and went on her way. At her fiancé's house, she met the parents and they visited for a while. They have a little dog that they've had for years. The whole time, that dog was at this young lady's feet. It followed her through the house, would not leave her side. When she stopped, the dog stopped. Where she sat, the dog sat. For 2 hours, the dog was the girl's best friend. When she was about to leave, the mother said, "We've had plenty of people over to our house, but this dog has never taken to anyone like you. There must be something very special about you." She didn't realize the dog liked the smell of Coke on her pants. Sometimes what we think is a disappointment is really the hand of God. His ways are not our ways. Instead of being frustrated by what doesn't work out, try a different approach and say, "God, I trust you. I may not understand it. It may be uncomfortable, but I know you wouldn't have allowed it if it wasn't going to work to my advantage." If you only knew what God is going to do, you'd stay in peace. If you only knew how He's going to connect the dots, you wouldn't fight everything that doesn't go your way. If you only knew how He's going to take your mistakes and make miracles out of them, how your poor choices are not going to stop your destiny, then you'd get your passion back. You'd stir your faith up and start dreaming again, start hoping again, Start believing again.
Thanks so much for watching today. If you want to see the full message, click the link in the description or go to joelosteen.com. We are praying for you and your family. It's going to be an awesome year. You wouldn't be alive unless God had something amazing up in front of you.
Stay in faith. We know God's got something amazing in store for you and your family. We'll see you next time.